So it's fantastic to see you all together again. How does it feel to be working as a trio once more?
It was great.
Yeah,
it was amazing. Really good. We started recording about almost 2 years ago, and yeah, it's been a while. Mm-hmm. And we basically just wanted to get together and, you know, hang out a little bit, see how we gelled, and yeah, it's been really fun.
So you were very young when you started out in the industry. Do you feel like it was a good move to start your career so early?
I feel like for us, for everyone, it's completely different. I think it's kind of difficult because, you know, we have been through a lot and, you know, it's not all of it was very positive, but in the end it was positive, and the things that we learned from it, you know, we wouldn't have been able to, we couldn't even give advice now if we hadn't gone through the things that we did.
I don't know if that's why we're here now. Really.
Yeah, but I don't know if we'd encourage people to get
that's
into
it. I feel really conflicted around it because I think we were individually really strong in our personalities, and even if there was negative stuff going on around us, we never got involved in anything like that. But like, would I want my children to start, you know, at 11 and 12 like we did? It's like, I mean, I even like,
you're still really
crazy. Yeah, I know. Yeah. It's crazy that we did it, but. I guess, you know, anyone that is like 11 and 12, like you think you're so much older than you are. Like, you kind of have to give people a bit of credit, you know. And I guess if we really wanted to do it like we did, our parents had to let us, or there would have been, you know, murders at home. So,
I guess. We felt passionate about doing it at that age, I guess.
Yeah. What advice would you give to a 16-year-old who wanted to get into the industry?
I think the one thing that we've definitely learned is that first of all, you have to really love what you do and be prepared to work hard. But most of all, it is the music business, so it's two separate things. And it's important to actually know the music just as well. I mean, the business just as well as, you know the music. Mm-hmm. And the business side is actually more important than the music side, because that's what you're dealing with probably 70, 80% of the time. Mm-hmm. And the music is literally a fraction of what you get to do. So I would literally just say that, you know, no matter what age you're coming into it, that it's important that you sort of really get to learn, you know, the behind the scenes work, you know, who does what, and you know, it seems all very boring, but it's very important.
Yeah, I mean, we learned through sort of like, it was our life experiences that sort of taught us to deal with the business. But I would say to people, if you can, then I would hang on to your education and take it as far as you can go with it. I mean, we kind of gave up schooling because the time would not allow in the end, and then you educate yourself through books. You know, there's all kinds of ways you can learn in life, but you should always try and continue to learn and grow as much as you can.
Has there ever been a point in your careers where you felt really discouraged by something that someone said to you?
Absolutely. I think we've all felt discouraged, and we've absolutely definitely all had our confidence knocked. And I've definitely been told, you know, you're not going to do this and things like that. But, you know, that's why I think it's so important to know who you are and really believe in yourself, because really the buck stops at you, because when everyone around you doesn't, it does fall back on what you believe and how you feel about yourself.
And also, it's how you judge your success. You know, don't beat yourself up.
You guys have reformed under MKS rather than Sugar Babes. Do you feel that you've left that part behind?
We'll always be like the Sugar Babes at the core of our hearts. We came up with the name when we were 11 and 12 years old. And it's really, you know, for us, what the Sugar Babes was and what it stood for was actually the way the harmonies were put together, the sound of it, more so than the name. And that's why we wanted to separate, you know, ourselves from the whole gimmick of the name. And we're very happy just being ourselves. I think it's a big statement. And
So what's next for MKS now?
Well, right now we're in the middle of promo for our new single, Flatline. And then we'll do two singles and then an album early next year. We're also, hopefully, we'll be planning a tour soon, which we're really excited about. And we just can't wait to go out there and meet some new fans and see the old ones and get to perform new material.